guys are going to be UF ELI students from Japan at the intermediate level. So let's begin. Hi, my name is Carmen.
I'm Miss Brianna.
And I'm Miss Dana.
So today for our lesson, we're going to learn how to create plans. We're going to learn what factors are important when we make plans. We're going to learn how to deal with curveball scenarios, and we're going to learn some difficulties that can occur when we make plans.
Thank you, Ms. Carmen. Hi, everyone. How was your weekend this weekend?
Good.
Yeah?
Too short.
Do you guys have any plans this weekend? Want to by raise a hand, any plans coming up this weekend? Homework.
Where are you?
Oh, Disney Orlando.
Oh, awesome. You back there?
Working.
Okay, sounds great. Okay, so I'm going to ask you guys to take out a sheet of paper right now and a pencil. And I'm going to ask you to brainstorm some ideas on, or some factors that come into play when you're making plans with someone. So like your plans to Orlando this weekend, what factors come into play when you're planning that with someone else? I'm going to give you guys about a minute or so to do that.
Oh my God.
should they make these plans at?
The afternoon.
The afternoon? Do you have a specific time, maybe?
2?
2? Okay, 2 p.m. All right, so time is a big factor into making plans. So based off of what time they're making these plans at and what their interests are, what activity would be best for them to do when they make these plans? Any ideas?
Yeah, go to lunch.
Go to lunch, okay, that's a good option. Yeah.
Go to the movies.
The movies, okay.
Anything?
I think those are both great options for the time they have planned. They can go see an early movie or get lunch, makes sense. So the big factors that come into play when you're making plans are people's interests, their location, the cost, and the time. Everybody got that? Any questions? Okay. I'm going to hand it off to Ms. Carney, and we're going to do a little protocol scenario.
Okay, so I want you all to get into groups of 3. You can choose your groups. There's going to be 7 groups, and if there's an uneven number, then we can have like a group of 4. Discuss and come up with a solution. So you're going to fill out your handouts once you come up with a solution, and then one group member is going to come up to the front and write down some factors that were problems as well as your group's solution. So whenever you're done, you come up to the board and write that. I'm going to give you guys a couple of minutes to complete this activity. I'll let you know when there's 2 minutes left.
Any questions?
Also some factors are
doctors were doing earlier, so availability and transportation.
Everybody look up to the board, please. Okay, so for factors that could be problems, just remember to refer back to the factors that we already went over. So, for example, availability, transportation, cost, weather. So you would write factors like that here once you're done. Right, so you complete your handout and then you kind of write what factors you're talking about.
Thank you. or someone is making a statement?
All right, so I'm going to give you all about a minute to finish writing on the board if you haven't already.
Ideal to meet and have brunch.
List two of those cities.
Okay, so what was your biggest factor?
It was where we were going to meet.
Location. And then what was your solution?
We were going to meet in the middle.
Okay, that's a good solution. All right, so if you all could please just pass up your worksheets to the front. You all did awesome. All right. Can you get everyone's attention?
You're gonna get a grand for this. No, an Oscar for anybody in this class.
All right. So we're gonna go over the list of factors again. Why is availability important? Someone want to answer?
You can't get together. You can't do the plan.
Okay. So if you can't be with your friend, there will be no plans. Why is location important?
Because you have to think about how to get to where you want to conduct your plans. Like if you don't have a car, or if there's a bus in the city, things like that.
Okay. Why is cost important?
If the activity that you wish to do with your group is too expensive, members may not want to.
Yes, or sometimes if the activity is too cheap, you're like, I don't want to do that. That's sketchy. All right. So weather.
You want to make sure what you're doing is like the appropriate settings. You want the right clothes, or you want to pick the best location for what you're doing. Miss Dana, what does sketchy mean?
So sketchy is when you don't have a good internal feeling. So if you ever go to a place and you just sort of get like a bad chill and it's not cold, like you're just like, oh, I don't really like how this place is going, that's how in America we call it sketchy.
Can you be suspicious to you, like someone?
Yes. Suspicious would also be in the family of sketchy.
Could you write it on the board?
Of course. Sketch. All right. So thank you all so much for today. You all have been great participants.